Alright, today I'm going to be showing you how to install Dwarf Fortress 0.44.10 as well as the new Beta 1 version of DFHack. I really can't play Dwarf Fortress without DFHack anymore. Alright, so first you'll need to go to bay12games.com/dwarves, click on your version of operating system. This tutorial is for Windows, so we'll click Windows. Wait for it to complete downloading. We'll go ahead and come over here, and I'm using a 64-bit version of Windows, so I'm going to click the 64-bit version right here. I'm also at github.com/dfhack/dfhack/releases. Both these links will be in the video description as well. So go ahead and click that. That needs to download. While that's going, we'll go to our downloads folder. I'm already over there. And I'm going to be installing it in my Documents, then my Games folder. So we're going to go ahead and click. I'll use the built-in tool to make it easier. So we'll extract it all into there. And then we'll be dragging that newly created folder into my Games. Here's the newly created folder. It's the launcher. Go ahead and drag that into there. Then we're going to double-click DFHack to open the file up. Open the Dwarf Fortress file and copy all the files in here with either Control-A or dragging. Copy it all. It should ask to replace one file. Is. All right, before we go ahead and launch, let's check out the dfhack.int example. Once we are satisfied with the settings, we can delete the dash example. I'm usually okay with the default. I recommend using a program like Notepad++. Using the regular Notepad will be quite the pain. My main usage of dfhack is for frames per second optimization, and also for what's called the Dwarf Manipulator, which is an in-game version of Dwarf Therapist. All right, and in this version of Dwarf Fortress, it'll be quite important because we're bringing back really the difficult part of Dwarf Fortress, which is happiness and everything like that. So I'm on the desktop over here. I'm going to go ahead and create a shortcut from the dwarffortress.exe. You can launch directly from here. I like to make a shortcut. So then we'll just right click on the desktop and click paste shortcuts. Then we can just clean that up, make it just say Dwarf Fortress, and there you go. All right, and then we can just double click. It'll launch two windows, one terminal and one other one. The first time you launch it, Windows 10 will warn you that it doesn't recognize it. Just click more info and then click run anyway. I have noticed that this version of Dwarf Fortress does take a little bit longer to get started. Sometimes with it not responding for a while, but usually it keeps going. You have to remember this is a beta release and the first version of 0.44.10. If you go to the DFHack release page, you'll see that it's you'll see the newest version of whichever one. Just make sure the version number matches the Dwarf Fortress version number. As you can see here, this is the warning you see when you do not rename your int file. So we can just delete that for next time, click yes, and then next time when we launch, we won't get that warning. This is the DFHack terminal. Here you can launch commands, do a bunch of really cool stuff. All right, including some cheating commands, which I don't really use, but sometimes I use Prospect to figure out what I can mine. Yeah. base build of DFHack. If we click create a new world, looks like we won't get a warning until we start to actually try to play the game. Probably going to start a tutorial series based off this new version, especially because there's a lot of new players out there who are not used to the difficulty that this version will bring. So yeah, it's going to be fun. All right, thank you guys, and see you soon.